so many questions about those photos. We're going to have to return to some of those photos. So we are going to start back in the early 60s. We're having to be vague here. She's got that in a contract. And apparently...
Very early.
Stirlingshire. Is that how we say it, Kaye? When a wee girl named Kaye arrived into the world and was welcomed into the arms of Mum Kathy and Dad Duncan, it was a very... You've always said, actually, Kaye.
Oh, yeah.
You had a very, very happy childhood, although your dad did call you smarty pants and thought you showed off too much.
Yeah, he did. He says, you're going just too far now. You're just going too far, toots. That's enough. I mean, and, you know, the older you get, I think, the more you kind of reflect on your childhood and you meet lots of people in their life who've... I mean, you were speaking to Kerry there, weren't we, who I have a great admiration for, and she had a tough childhood. I was blessed with my childhood and how supportive my mum and dad were. And as you get older, that's Charlie and my dad, as you get older, you realise... I realise it's almost the best fortune you can possibly
The biggest privilege.
Yeah. 100%. It really is.
Yeah, to be born into a loving, supportive family, you know, and obviously Mum and Dad aren't here anymore. But now I've got to the stage, I suppose, it'll actually be 3 years in a couple of weeks since Mum died. I've got to the stage that I can be really, really thankful for having had them. And having had that life.
It almost makes it harder, because I remember when you lost your mum and dad and they were quite close together.
Yeah.
And when you've got an incredible family that have just been amazing and raised you so well, is it then harder to carry on life without them?
You know, I thought about that a lot when they were both ill. I'm not going to suddenly get morbid here. You know, the thought of losing them was just inconceivable. And sometimes, you know, you're sitting there in the long, dark night thinking, would this be easier if I didn't love them so much? You know, and I don't know the answer to that because I've not been in that situation. But I don't think so. How can you regret having had wonderful parents? You just can't, because I mean, it's a great fortune.
Also, going back, you say, obviously, that you had that amazingly happy foundation, which is crucial, but also you had a working mum, didn't you? And I think that has really shaped you.
Yeah. Well, it has, and a lot of the conversations we have on Loose Women about mum guilt and should women go back to work and should... To a certain extent, no, I don't mean they go over my head, but because from the earliest of ages, like, my mum and dad worked in a business together, they set up a business together, and, you know, my mum was a very feisty character, and my dad was kind of, you know, the charmer. And so I saw a very strong woman from the very beginning, and, you know... my dad was a strong character too, but, you know, and they often butted heads against each other, so I saw equality. Every single day of my life, I saw equality.
And they had a very passionate relationship, didn't
they?
Yeah,
they
loved
each other.
Your mum was crazy about your dad.
Yeah, no, they I mean, as I say, they had some great fights, but you knew they really cared about each other. And as I say, my mum worked the whole way, so, you know, I never learned to cook because my mum was the worst cook in the world and she'd be the first person. I think she tried to make scones once and they came out like rich tea biscuits and she kind of gave up.
But I like that you talk about that you had incredible freedom, didn't you, as a kid? I think you once did call yourself the latchkey kid.
Oh, no,
you would
not
come home, your mum
all
would...
the time.
Yeah.
I did that with my mum all the time, because you always find a little niggle with your mum, don't you, that makes her feel horribly guilty. And with me, I would go, well, I'm just a latchkey kid because you don't come in till 6 o'clock and I've got to open up my own Heinz lentil soup, which is my favourite. but actually, I loved that freedom. But I also loved the fact that she'd say, all right, then, what do you want? You know.
And what were you like at school? Because, you know, we joke about... We always get... You and I get cast as the sensible ones here. But were you sensible at school?
Well, actually, I was a bit of a class clown, funnily enough. There was a picture there with me and my school pal, Judith, and she will be... furious that I've showed that.
Don't look very clowny there, Kaye, I have to say.
No, but people underestimate Kaye. People don't expect Kaye to be as funny and as silly as you are. You are I think you're one of the silliest out of all of us.
Thank you, Steve.
I love it.
I take that as a real compliment.
It is a compliment.
I was I was studious, you know, so I was sensible, but I was also a bit of a class clown as well.
But you always had ambitions to leave where you were from, didn't you? Like, I remember you telling me a story about you would always be looking for the house where you wanted to live outside of
Wavell. Horrible wee
snob. And the private schools you wanted to go to.
It was terrible. Terrible. Real hyacinth bouquet. yeah, well, I suppose, again, my mum and dad, you know... Like, my granny was a cleaner in the hospital. My grandpa was a miner. On the other side, it was similar, but really great, decent, you know, hardworking people. And then my mum and dad, you know, at that time, they kind of stepped up a little bit. My mum became a nurse. Nobody else had become qualified in that way. My dad left school at 13 and sort of built a business and things. So I guess that is just ingrained in you in some way, that you want to sort of say, right, well, how can I kind of...
survive.
Do better, because, you know, I was born in a place, you know, called Grangemouth, which I still love, and my mum and dad...
I love Grangemouth.
Yeah, so... yeah. So it's not that you're ashamed of where you come from at all. Great place and great people, but... you want to do more, you want to see more, you want to meet different people, explore. You want to put yourself in different
situations. And it was kind of you who decided to go to uni, wasn't it, rather than actually be pushed in that direction?
Yeah, well, neither my mum and dad had been to university, so yeah. It wasn't particularly a thing for them. I mean, they were pleased that I went, but, you know, I mean, it was, that's nice, Kaye, well done.
You know, and you loved university, didn't you? And you met your great friend, Ross Kelly, there.
Yes,
from
I did.
TVAM. Yeah. I hope we've got the photograph of him in his trunks, because he looks
you're
so
You're rubbing
lovely.
Your thighs in a rather unfortunate fashion when you say that. I don't know whether they've got Ross in his trunks. Yeah, Ross Kelly.
Oh, there he is. Oh,
look at you both there, living the life.
So there's Ross, and lots of people recognise Ross from the telly, GMTV and This Morning and various things. So we met at uni and we've been great friends ever since. And so I would go on lots of holidays with Ross, which I could almost hear the people around us going, well, she's punching above her weight. I mean, could you imagine having to go on the beach with Ross looking like that? Oh, my God. I said, we're not together. And people would go, yeah, I can tell. You're obviously the friend. But, yeah, we've
And did you do journalism
forever.
At uni? Because you wanted to be a lawyer, didn't you? But was it journalism you did at uni?
No, I did politics and economics.
She's very, very...
She wanted to be a corporate lawyer.
That's yeah, no, I wanted to be a criminal lawyer. I wanted to do that thing where I would stride around a court and I'll put it to you. But I didn't have the brains for that, so I'm just putting it to you instead.
hence why you're the anchor.
Yes.
So when did journalism come into the picture?
At university, they had the classic thing, the student... newspaper magazine. There was two. One was really successful, all the clever people were on, and one couldn't attract anyone, so it got me and Ross. So we decided to shimmy our way into it. And so it was that, literally, you know, being
on
the student newspaper and thinking, God, I love this. You know, I just love finding out stories, and, well, Ross is a much better writer than I am. But it clicked. I thought, this is what I want to do. Yeah, which was good.